The Ogallala Aquifer is underneath 8 states in the central U.S., and it covers approximately 170,000 square miles. It's the water source for the breadbasket of the U.S.
We've got a little over 1 million acres of irrigated cropland, and a lot of these wells are dropping off.
We are starting to deplete the aquifer. You know, it was, hey, we got water, this here will last forever. Well, no, it's not gonna last forever.
Water's the lifeblood of our area. Without water that we have underneath us, it would be like farming a desert. Our operation has grown since I first arrived in Moore County in 79 to 8,500 acres. We are predominantly all corn. I'm Harold Grawl. I'm a farmer in Moore County in the North Texas Panhandle. It has been a great life. This is what I consider my calling in life. It's to be able to farm. Things have changed dramatically over the years. When I first got here, we had abundant water. And then we got into the 90s, and weather started changing, and especially into the 2000s. It seems like weather was a lot more volatile. But it hadn't been until since 2007 that we've seen commodity prices on the rise that farming has proved to be very profitable for us. As farming has become more profitable, we're seeing more development all around us. So with all this new demand in our area, the water's dropping off a lot more quickly in season.
Okay, this is our source well.
So it's a huge challenge. Here we are, we're trying to leave water behind for our next generation, and at the same time, maintain profitability for our existing operation. There's a sense of urgency here. We need to do something. We can't be stopping and waiting 2 or 3 years before we start acting.
When we're coming out to work with these guys, usually they've contacted us and have a problem.
I'm Mike Caldwell. I'm the district conservationist with the NRCS in the Dumas Field Office.
Our area that we cover is big. We have to drive a lot of miles to see these guys and to be out in the field with them to know what's going on. And I think there's no substitute for being on the ground.
How much water do y'all have here, do you remember?
We have 2,400 gallons.
We probably spend 90% of our time assisting producers with irrigation projects, replacing pipelines, doing nozzle conversions where we can lower those drops, those sprinkler drops, down into the crop canopy.
And if you have this thing in spray mode, you're going to have water spraying up in air. And between the sunshine and the wind blowing, you're going to lose a lot of your water.
To evaporation. Harold's real innovative and is open to adopting new practices. He does a lot of no-till and strip-till farming.
NRCS plays a big part in this by giving us a funding available to be able to expand like our demonstration project.
What they're trying to do is show that they can grow somewhere in the neighborhood of 200 bushels of corn on 12 inches of water. And Harold's field that's in this project is in an area that's pretty low on water. And just looking at the field the last few days, the corn looks good. If they can get it to dry down and get it harvested, it'll be interesting to see what the yields are.
Looks like the yields are gonna be a little bit higher than last year.
These guys have done some things that their practices, they've done them for years, and it's hard for them to change. And I think that goes with anything. But a lot of these guys, I think necessity and you know, just seeing their neighbor, he's doing some good things. So they're, you know, it's coming around.
These producers know that the aquifer is depleted, and they know that they need to use the water in the most efficient manner that they can. Probably over the last 6 years, we've started growing quite a few acres of cotton, and it's a plant that's not using as much water, and they can rotate with other crops and include cotton in that rotation. Hey, David.
Hi, Mike.
David Ford's one of our more progressive farmers.
I'm David Ford. I'm a third-generation farmer in Moore and Hartley counties. Cotton is a crop that will respond to a little bit of water at the right time will make an awful lot of difference in what it'll yield. And it doesn't have to be a whole lot of water. We're having to learn, if we're going to continue to farm in this area under irrigation, we've got to change the way we're doing things, and we are.
We're going to put wheat back here.
I've gone to using strip tillage. We don't till the ground and rip it like we used to. Plow the ground so many times, it would look like a garden. With strip tillage, we leave an awful lot of organic matter on the ground, which helps keep the water from running off.
Would have earlier. In there,
yeah. Yeah, there's still some moisture in it. A week ago, my grandson was going to church with us, and my wife asked him, "What do you want to do when you grow up?" He said, "Well, I want to farm." And she said, "Well, what if you can't farm?" And he looked at her and kind of frowned like, "But I want to farm." You know, we've got to be better stewards of what God made and what we've got, because there's not going to be any more of it.
The Natural Resources Conservation Service helped these guys improve their efficiency, and they're doing everything that they can to get the most use out of every drop.
We've talked about water conservation, and that's a nice word, but when it comes right down to doing it, and doing it at the extent that we need to now, we can't do it by ourselves. We got to have that helping hand out there to help us do that.